कोरोना महामारी दौरान मारे गए ते दुख सहन वाले यूके वासियों लिए हमदर्दी जतांदिया एमपी तनमनजीत सिंह ढेसी ने संसद च बोलदिया कहा कि कोविड 19 तालाबंदी दौरान काफ़ी लोगों ने इस दर्द को हंडाया। इस दौरान तनमनजीत सिंह ढेसी काफ़ी गुस्से च नज़र आ रहे सन क्योंकि वह उन्होंने लोगों तो नाराज दिखाई दे रहे सन जिन्होंने इस दौरान नियमों दियां धज्जियां उड़ाईया ने। उन्हों का कहना है कि इस दौरान मैं अपनी दादी नूं अंतिम बार नहीं देख सकिया, पर सरकार दे सलाहकार डोमिनिक कमिंग्स ते होर लोग नियमों दियां धज्जियां उड़ाते रहे। टोरी मंत्री मिस्टर कमिंगसन नूं बचाउण दियां कोशिशां करते रहे। प्रधानमंत्री बोरिस जॉनसन ने सेहत मंत्री मैट हनहुक नूं तुरंत सरकार तो फारग करन लई वी क्यों देरी कीती। सवालों के जवाब च प्रधानमंत्री बोरिस जॉनसन ने देशवासियों तो जिथे माफ़ी मंगी उथे उन्हें कहा कि जान वालों नूं वापस नहीं लिया जा सकता, पर फिर भी वह पूरे यूके वासियों तो माफ़ी मंगते ने।
भोगते आए थे उस टाइम तो सारे बोल के गए कि जॉब का ही बहुत जल्दी काम हो जाएगा। कभी कहते ने कि सानू प्रूफ लिया के दिखाओ कि हाँ कोरोना नाल ही डेथ हुई थी। असी झूठ थोड़ी बोलेंगे कि कोरोना नाल नहीं हुई थी। साढ़े घर की हालत भी ठीक नहीं है। साढ़े घर च सिर्फ मेरे हसबेंड ही जो जॉब करते हूँ 8-9 महीने हो गए ने, कोई भी इनकम का साधन नहीं है और साढ़े को।
मुख मंत्री दे सुरक्षा दस्ते दा सिपाही, मां बाप, पत्नी ते बच्चियां दा एक मात्र सहारा इकलौता कमाऊ पुत सी शहीद जसपाल सिंह, जो कि अपना फर्ज निभाउंदिआं कोरोना दे कारण शहीद हो गया। कि अजे भी ये परिवार तरस दे आधार ते नौकरी दे लायक नहीं? अमीर मंत्रियां दे ये बच्चे महंगीआं गड्डियां ते करोड़ां दी संपत्ति दे मालक, कि ये लोग सचमुच तरस दे पात्र ने?
पंजाब मंग दा जवाब।
Grandmother, whom I love dearly, was lying on a hospital deathbed, and none of us were allowed to be there to comfort her in her final moments. I couldn't even carry her coffin on my shoulders. I also had to endure the agony of watching alone online the funeral of my uncle, my fun-loving uncle, and we were not there to comfort my brother-in-law's father, who had somehow contracted COVID in a Slough care home, during his final moments. All this because we followed government guidance. Yep. Having experienced such painful personal sacrifices, like many others, imagine our collective disgust when, in order to curry favour with the Prime Minister's chief advisor, we see psychophantic, spineless, hypocritical government ministers lining up to defend the indefensible, saying it's time to move on, with some even having the gall to tell us that they too go for a long drive when they need to get their eyesight tested. What an absolute disgrace, and they shall be thoroughly ashamed of themselves. So when is the Prime Minister finally going to apologise to the nation for not mustering up some courage and integrity, for doing the honourable thing and sacking his chief advisor, who so shamelessly flouted his own government guidance, so that he could have regained that lost public trust and confidence, and he could have demonstrated that it's not one rule for him and his elite chums, and another for the rest of us plebs?
Perhaps the best thing I can say, Mr. Speaker, is how deeply I think I, the government, everybody sympathises with those who have gone through the suffering described by the gentleman opposite. And no one can, who hasn't been through something like that, can imagine what it must feel like to be deprived of the ability to mourn properly, to hold the hands of a loved one in their last moments in the way that the Honourable Gentleman describes. And I know how much sympathy there will be with him. I take his criticisms most sincerely of the government and everything that we have done, but all I can say, we have tried throughout this pandemic to minimise human suffering, to minimise loss of life, and for where we have, and for, as I've said before, when he asks me to apologise, I do. I apologise for the suffering that the people of this country have endured, and all I can say is that nothing and I can say or do can take back the lost lives, the lost time spent with loved ones that he describes, and I'm deeply, deeply sorry for that.
लंदन तो मनप्रीत सिंह बद्री कला की रिपोर्ट। वधेरे खबरों लिए तुसी देखते रहो जीत वैब टीवी।